In this week market movers, Vale's Brazilian woes take their toll on Europe's steel market, and a strong start is expected for a brand new price assessment in petrochemicals. But first, oil market participants will hold their breath this week as unseasonable strength in the European fuel oil market continues to surpass market expectations. The dirty product strength has come amid demand from Singapore and Saudi Arabia due to profitable arbitrage windows. The front month 3.5% sulfur Rotterdam barge crack spread, which measured the relative price of the product compared with crude oil, hit an all-time high last week. Meanwhile, fuel oil discount compared with more valuable gasoline narrowed to a fresh low. The European gasoline market is likely to continue to struggle in the coming week, with arbitrage windows to both the US and West Africa staying firmly closed. Platts key ethanol FOB Rotterdam benchmark looks set to continue. That leads us to this week's social media question. Will current dynamics in the refined product market persist? Tweet us your thoughts, as always, with the hashtag PlattsMM. In metals, all eyes would be this week on European steel product prices. On January 25th, a dam collapsed in one of Vale iron ore mines in Minas Gerais, Brazil. Vale is the world's largest iron ore producer, and the price of basic 62% iron ore has jumped by close to 30% since the accident. As a result, steelmakers ArcelorMittal, Arvedi and British Steel have hiked prices by as much as 30 euros per metric ton for some of their products since early February. That's despite widespread expectation of a slowdown in European steel market growth rates this year. Market sentiment has been aggravated by a suggestion that Vale might have to prioritise Brazilian mills' need for pellets and other products at the expense of export customers in Europe and elsewhere. From iron ore to coal and a plentiful supply of Russian coal, high European stockpiles and mild weather are contributing to drop in prices amid weak Asian demand. There has been a drop in delivery European thermal coal prices in the last 3 weeks, as you can see from the purple line on the chart. From over $85 per metric ton to in mid-January, the price for thermal coal delivered to Northwest Europe fell to a little over $70 per metric ton last Friday. It previously had not dropped below $70 since early 2017. Continued weakness over the coming week would continue to push out US coals, which are fighting for market share against high calorific value, low sulfur Russian coals. Also, in generating fuels, US officials are expected to encourage German officials to support building LNG import infrastructure at a meeting in Berlin this week. US Deputy Energy Secretary Jan Bruyette is set to discuss the issue with the German government on Tuesday. There are three projects competing for support from Berlin, where the government is keen to diversify gas supplies in light of the country's planned coal phase-out. A ministry official said last week that at least one terminal will be built. The US has been a vocal supporter of German plans for LNG import infrastructure. It sees this as an alternative to Russian pipeline gas. President Donald Trump last year said Germany was captive to gas supplies from Moscow. Finally, S&P Global Platts launched a new assessment last week for polyethylene terephthalate, otherwise known as PET. The plastic is used to make items such as bottles and food packaging. PET is likely to see particularly strong demand in Europe as companies increase efforts to include more recycled content in the plastic packaging. Buyers will be looking to lock in margins for this week, as many industry sources expect prices to rise. You can find a new food-grade PET pellet assessment in Polymer Scan and Plus Petrochemical Alert, page 506. That's it for this week. Thank you for kicking off your Monday with us, and have a great week ahead.